Hello? Please, help me.
We are currently experiencing technical problems.
Good evening, everyone. This is Brother Lloyd, also known as 287. And to those who are keeping the Sabbath this evening, I hope you're having a blessed and peaceful Sabbath. I wanted to do a quick commentary this evening on a news piece that I saw. It was on Fox News. And I just want to illustrate a couple of points in it and really just show some of the foolishness that the enemy has people focusing on when actually they should be focusing toward the Father. Here it is. There was a four-person news panel, and they were discussing the depiction of Santa Claus being always shown as a white man. As soon as I started to hear this story, I went straight to where most people should be going with it. And really, it's a point of why should anyone care literally about it at all? But that's really a select few that really understand that this is really non-irrelevant. It's non-newsworthy, but that's how society has been conditioned to be concerned about all these things, especially at this time of year. And in this panel, they were discussing the issue of Santa Claus. So I'm going to show it, and then I'm going to come back with my commentary.
Santa Claus should not be a white man anymore. And when I saw this headline, I kind of laughed, and I said, oh, this is so ridiculous. Yet another person claiming it's racist to have a white Santa. You know, and by the way, for all you kids watching at home, Santa just is white, but this person is just arguing that maybe we should also have a black Santa. But, you know, Santa is what he is, and just so you know, we're just debating this because someone wrote about it, kids. Okay, I wanted to get that straight. But Jedediah, when I read the piece, the author seems to have, you know, she's African American, and she seems to have real pain at having grown up with this image of a white Santa, and she speaks about it kind of honestly, saying, I didn't really understand. Just because it makes you feel uncomfortable doesn't mean it has to change. You know, I mean, Jesus was a white man too. But you know, it's like we have, he was a historical figure. I mean, that's verifiable fact. As is Santa. I just want the kids watching to know that.
Okay, if you notice, This is a serious discussion about Santa Claus, him being a white man or being depicted as a white individual, and this writer's issue with him being white, and all this banter back and forth about what he should be, shouldn't be, why does everything have to change, all that. It's total foolishness. I'm telling you people, the enemy has people so wound up and distracted that it makes no sense. Now, my first point is we are talking about a fictional character, a fairy tale, something that's not even real, something that has never been real. And if you literally took the time to do your homework, the scripture speaks about this Christmas thing, this decorating thing. All these symbols, trees, and all these different things, if you took the time to literally do your homework as to what all this symbolism mean, you would seriously consider not celebrating Christmas yourself, because really we shouldn't be. The long and short of it is, Christmas is a culmination of a whole heap of different celebrations and traditions, and most of them are rooted in evilness and debauchery and murder and mayhem and what have you. But it's all been presented as this beautiful, wonderful thing, and then the coup de grace of it is we've put our Savior on top of it as if December 25th is his birthday. Now, I'm going to make a little commentary on that right quick. There is nothing in scripture remotely that says his birthday is December 25th. This came from the Romans and all those folks back then. December 25th, more than anything, is the birthday of many deities, Tammuz being one of them. Our Savior was clumped in that to bring people into the fold of celebrating all these things. So, Tammuz, our Savior, Yahshua, Jesus, he's been clumped in with all this. And there's several deities, false deities, all of them, except for our Savior, whose birthdays are celebrated on December 25th. So this has been fed to everyone, and everyone has bought it hook, line, and sinker. Now, scripture tells us that, if you understand it, if you study it, that our Savior was born sometime in the fall. Now, if you think about it, this is exactly the reason why scripture doesn't tell us exactly when our Savior was born, because people have become so focused and locked in on celebrating December 25th as his birthday and as a reason to do all these things that it only makes sense that they wouldn't focus on the truth of the matter, which is our Savior. Look at how people celebrate Christmas. They don't really focus on their Savior at all. They may play the music. They may go back and forth to church on Christmas Day or what have you. But it's all about money, giving, and getting, and eating, and all these things we shouldn't be doing, and then all these celebrating. This is what people do on December 25th. So it makes sense that Scripture didn't put emphasis on the day. Yes, his birth is extremely important, because without it, we'd all be lost. But we shouldn't be focused on a particular day when it comes to his birth, because that's not so much important, that day, as it is him being born and all that it ended up representing. That's what's important, or that's what should be important to all of us. But in all this foolishness, back to the news story, our Savior has always been presented to us, especially in this country, as a Caucasian white man. But the point is, when you get so caught up and you're going to argue something as insignificant as Santa Claus and then make a comparison to our Savior in it, and you're doing nothing of the sort to show that you're living for him or doing for him, it's just total chaos and foolishness. And this is where the enemy has people so caught up and wound up and just looking as total fools. And it just struck me when I saw this that we all need to really pay attention to the things that get us caught up, that don't focus on the Father. This Santa thing, really, a lot of you all really need to come away from it. There's nothing good in it. It's all foolishness and mayhem that the enemy revels in. All these things are what the Father has purposed us not be part of. And if we did what we're supposed to do, we would have no part in that, because we start to see the fruit of that madness as time goes on. But as a society, so many people are caught up in pleasing and conditioning their children into all this madness that they can't come away from it, because that's how they were raised, that's how their parents were raised, and we have to keep these traditions and blah, 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 blah. You should come away from it and teach your children the word, how to be obedient and loyal to the Father in his word. Teach them the truth, because it serves them no purpose when you help deceive them from the deception you already know is a deception. Anyway, I just wanted to show you all that and make a couple of points about it. And with that being said, I am done with that mess. This is Brother Lloyd, 287. I'm out.